Hi guys, I've had quite a few people have been asking me about this wool top that I wear. I've been wearing it for the last year or so, and I saw a video that Dave Cansby made on making a wool top, a wool shirt from a blanket, and that sort of prompted me really to making a video about this top. As I said, I made this last, I can't remember, February time, I think, January, February last year. And you'll have seen it in lots of my videos. I've worn it throughout the year, particularly in the evenings, around the fire and things like that. And it is made from a wool blanket. In my very, very early videos, you see me using a white blanket to sleep in. This is this blanket. And the reason I made it is, obviously, wool is very warm. It's excellent around a fire. You can sleep in it. It's just a really useful, versatile garment. The problem is you can buy wool garments or wool shirts, but they're a fortune. And you can buy an army surplus blanket for a fiver if you buy a British one. If you buy like the Italian or the Dutch one, you're about 25 to 50 quid, depending on where you get them from. But wool blankets you can get really cheap. You know, go to antique shops and things like that. So my design, what I've done, I've got it longer at the back than it is at the front. So the tail almost comes down to the back of my knees. And the reason I designed that into it is so that if I sit down, I've got something wool underneath me. But it's still some insulation between me and whatever I'm sitting on. So I can put a waterproof mat down on the ground, for example, and I've got wool between me and the ground. The front comes down to my mid-thigh. Again, to keep warmth around my main area. I haven't bothered putting a collar on it. One, because it was too difficult to sew a collar. I tried and I couldn't get it to look right. But you know, you don't need a collar with this type of shirt. The collar I was gonna try and make was gonna be a really long collar that came right down past the shoulders. It's almost like a second lining, so like a second layer here, which have been mainly for the rain. But I don't wear this in the rain. If it's wet, I'll put my poncho over the top. And I made the arms extra long. Two reasons again. One, because the width of the blanket determined how wide the shirt was going to be. So I had to sew extensions on to the cuffs to make them fit my arms. But then I purposely made the sleeves too long so that during the winter I can actually unfold my arms, or at night time when it's cold, unfold the cuffs, and I've got a covering over my hands. The sides of this shirt, also, I've made the seams split quite a long way up. And that's so I've got easy access to get to my knife, or my possibles pouch, or whatever else I'm wearing in my pockets. Sorry, I don't wear a possibles pouch, but my tinder bag, my roly-poly bag. So those are the design features I put into this shirt. There's no buttons on it, there's no zips on it, there's no cords on it. It's just you put it over your head and it's there you go. There's only two seams in it, and they run up both sides and under the arms. There is no seams across the top of the shoulders, and under the arms, to make it fit right so it's comfy, you need to sew a diamond-shaped gusset into the armpit. So that's my shirt. It's quite easy to make. Literally, it's two seams running down either side of the shirt. Have a go, guys. It's fun to make. It's very warm, very versatile. As I said, I've slept in it several nights, especially during the summer. You know, it saves taking a blanket if you don't want to take a blanket with you. And have fun, guys. See you soon.